epic night in Birmingham, ups and downs, and more ups and more downs, and a brilliant main event as ever. Thrilling from Amir Khan. And Amir, a few words first on your victory before we go to the floor.
Yeah, first of all, thanks for all being here, guys. You know, we just met Samuel Vargas. I have to say, you know, he came to win today. I've been in the ring with many fighters where when you put it on them, you put with the, you hit with a good combination, they start backing off. You don't want to get hurt, but with Samuel Vargas, he kept coming forward and wouldn't take a step back. Then I had to go back to boxing skills. I caught him early in the fight, put him down. Then he put me down with a shot which I just didn't see. Got over the top with a right hand. He hit me and got straight up. I wasn't buzzed. Got off, shook myself off, and then I thought in the fifth round I thought I had him up. I had him gone. Then cut his face up and I thought he's gone. I had him on the ropes and couldn't believe the referee kept let him go on. But then again, it was good because when I'm in the corner, Joe did say to me, "Look, we want to go the full distance with this guy. We want to get the round under our belt because." If you look at the last fight against LeGreco, can't really call that a fight. It happened in 39 seconds. This fight, we got everything we needed to. We got experience. We got being in the ring, doing 12 rounds, getting the feel of being in the ring again. You know, I mean, last time I went more than one round was about 3 years ago. You know, so I'm very happy with my performance. I'm happy with the way the fight was. I want to thank Birmingham for turning out and being such great fans, and had nothing against Samuel Vargas. Samuel Vargas is a great fighter, and I wish him all the best. I don't think he's ever trained as hard. I mean, he said it himself, he's never trained so hard for a fight in his whole career. I mean, why does Eddie give all these guys 10 weeks? I mean, he's telling me that when he fought Garcia, you know, like a week, and when he fought Spencer, like 2 weeks. I'm like, why didn't he get like 3 weeks against me? At least 3 weeks would have been alright, but I mean, to get 10 weeks. But look, this is boxing. I only want to fight the best. And I'm happy with the performance. You can say what you want. I'm happy the way the fight went. And I learned so much from this fight than I would have if I knocked him out in one or two rounds.
Guys, open to the floor.
In your opinion, your preference, take everyone else out of the equation. Would you prefer Manny or Kell Brook next?
Look, both fights are massive. But Manny is someone I would love to fight first.
You've always wanted that one, haven't you?
I've always wanted that fight before in Kell Brook, you know? Yeah. I mean, we train together and I do so well against southpaws. I do better with southpaws than I do with the orthodox fighters. I've got 100% record against them and it'd be more like a technical, tactical fight, you know? But let's see what happens. I mean, me and Eddie are going to sit down next week and see what the options are. End of the day, look, we're businessmen and what makes financial. What makes the best financial movement? We can take that.
Eddie, what do you think's most likely?
Again, as Amir said, like it's all about the money that's on offer. I mean, we haven't yet sat down and look at the black and white numbers and said this is the Pacquiao fight, this is the Brook fight. And the truth is we don't know the exact number we can get Manny Pacquiao for yet, and we don't know the exact number we can get Kell Brook for yet. So there's a lot of work to do. Financially, they're both huge fights, huge fights. In fact, if the fights take place in the UK, the Brook fight makes more money for Amir Khan for various reasons. But there is the opportunity, the Pacquiao fight, to attract international money to that fight. The Pacquiao fight is a bigger fight than the Brook fight internationally. The Brook fight is a bigger fight for Britain. But Amir is a global star, and we have to look at all kinds of different things. But, you know, the two initial fights that we planned, done with. And the most pleasing thing is that he got 12 rounds, because I see that as the comeback fight after Canelo, not Phil LeGreco. So to put on a performance like that after being out for so long, I think he's great. And then we'll sit down next week. I think the main thing to look at is, does Amir Khan box in December or does he box in February? Because Manny Pacquiao wants to box in December, and actually so does Kell Brook. So, you know, it's a case of if the opportunity arises, I think he jumps into a December fight. But again, the next 2 weeks are crucial to map everything out. And again, it's just a numbers game at the end of the day. You know, all these guys now, Kell, Amir, Manny, they're all in the final phases of their career. They want the biggest fights possible for the biggest amount of money.
And have you got a date and a venue penciled in?
I think we look at the 15th or the 22nd. You know, I mean, there's rumours of other fights on the 1st and stuff like that. And I think he'd need as much time as possible. But, you know, I think Millennium Stadium is an option. Vegas is an option. You know, Dubai, Abu Dhabi, you know, these places have always rumoured to come up with money for fights that haven't yet materialised. But one day they will.
Hmm. Garcia fights Porter tonight as well. Would you consider one of those after this?
Yeah, I mean, if it makes sense, definitely. And it'll be for a world title. I would love to take that fight though, if that option came.
Who would you pick?
In that fight, I got Garcia winning. I mean, we have a bit of history, so I'd like to fight a Garcia fight.
Joe, second fight with Amir, how do you assess his performance tonight?
I don't think there's any denying that he thoroughly outboxed, you know, Sammy Vargas tonight. It looked like he was going to have Vargas out in the first round. And I was going, oh no, not again, here we go. And, you know, two rounds of fighting over the two fights, you know, you do want your fighter to get some rounds in, you know, get the rust off because, you know, he was out for quite a while. Now, I think he had it going his way so easily in the first round and part of the second that he just got let his guard down in the second round. Other than that punch, you know, there was really not much of consequence that Vargas was able to do to him. And he came very well prepared. And we knew it. And we trained hard. We trained as if we were fighting the toughest guy in the world. But I gotta say, I think the performance was fantastic. Look at, I mean, poor Sammy took a lot of shots. I thought they were going to stop it in the fifth round. With that flurry, there were several times he got hurt. He got dropped. He took that flurry on the ropes. He got sent to the ropes another time where the ropes saved him from going down. He took a thorough thrashing tonight, but showed his mettle. He was just really brave and really in great shape. And he came here to win, no doubt. This was no guy coming here to pick up a paycheck. So. He raised his game and he raised his reputation tonight by putting on a great, great, determined performance. Unfortunately, he ran into a guy and he said it as much in the locker room. He goes, your legs are just, you know, I've never fought anybody with legs like yours. In other words, how he can outmaneuver guys. And he did well, and then he would flurry and hit this guy with hard, solid shots. You saw the blood coming out of the mouth. The nose was cut, the eyes were swollen. This guy kept on coming, so. You know, I think even higher rated guys wouldn't have taken the punishment that Sam took tonight and kept coming. I thought it was a brilliant performance.
Joe, two questions. What went through your mind with the early knockdown when Amir got knocked down? What did you tell him?
I did not panic in the least because, it's, you know, when you train like he did, he ran 6 days a week for 10 weeks, yeah. Okay? He was in the gym 6 days a week for 10 weeks. And I've been in fights before where guys get clipped with good shots and they go down. They go down hard, but they get up strong, and that's exactly what happened. You know, he got clipped with a good shot because he got a little complacent. You know, he had it going his way. And you lose that little bit of concentration, a guy could sneak one in on you, and that's exactly what happened. And that was the last time a big shot hit him like that during the course of the night. So, but Amir got up strong, clear-headed. We were conversing in the corner about what he had to do. And Amir remembers exactly what happened, so it was not something that took him an out-of-body experience. He got knocked down, he got right back up at the count of three, and was fine.
Yeah. Amir, you've said that your next fight, you want it to be a big one. How likely is it that could be the last fight of your career?
No, I mean, look, I still got love for the sport. You know, I take every fight step at a time. And fight. I mean, I have had a lot of wars. I've had 37 fights. Sometimes I forget how many fights I've had. So, you know, let's see what the next option is. Have that fight, see how I feel after that fight, and then just take it from there, really. I'm not saying one fight, I'm done after two fights, I'm done. I don't know exactly, I just want to know how I feel. You know, I still love training, I still love to learn, I still want to be the best, I still want to fight the best. I mean, that's what I am.
But what is there left for you to achieve?
You know, I want a super fight. I like a super fight with a massive name. I love a stadium fight. There's names out there like Brooke, there's names out there like Pacquiao. So, I mean, I think that would be perfect.
One question for our Urdu audience. Like, Pacquiao मुकाबला जीते हैं तो कैसा महसूस करते हैं और आप कैसा देखते हैं पाकिस्तानी जो रुझान है ब्रिटिश पाकिस्तानियों में जो टैलेंट है उसको किस तरह देखते हैं खासतौर पर आपको देखते हुए जो बॉक्सिंग
पाकिस्तान का टैलेंट बहुत अच्छा है मैं मेरी फाइट थी और वो कैच भी था और उस्मान असलम भी था आज पाकिस्तान स्लोली स्लोली बॉक्सर्स आर गेटिंग मोर इन्वॉल्व्ड और पाकिस्तान में भी ऐसे फाइटर्स मैंने खोली है एक जिम आमिर खान एकेडमी उधर भी फाइटर्स जाते हैं ट्रेनिंग करने के लिए बॉक्सर्स जाते हैं पाकिस्तान के उधर ट्रेनिंग करने के लिए सो इट्स वेरी गुड एंड आई थिंक वी जस्ट हैव टू मोटिवेट नाउ अभी इमरान खान इज प्राइम मिनिस्टर सो आई थिंक इमरान खान शुड प्रमोट स्पोर्ट And I think Imran will. I really think he will promote because wo bhi sportsman hai. So I think humko bas boxing academies aur kholne udhar Pakistan mein. Meri wo boxing league shuru hogi inshallah February. Aur inshallah uske baad hum dekhenge. But aaj dekho UK mein kitne Pakistani boxers hai. Pakistan mein bhi aise hona chahiye.
Hey,
do you
want to
translate?
I thought he was spot on. I agree with everybody.
Eddie, does the recent DAZN USA deal make a fight over in the USA more likely now?
Well, it's great news because when Amir signed us, we didn't have a US deal, so he's in a great position in that respect. And it's good for us as well because Amir's a big name in the States, so he has the opportunity to box wherever he wants. There's a stadium fight in the UK, there's a Vegas fight, you know, he's done that already. He hasn't done the stadium fight in the UK. Manny's not mad on the US fight for various reasons. But, you know, I think right now every single option is open. You know, an international fight, the Millennium Stadium, Vegas, you know, and we've got the money to put it up in the States, we've got the money to put it up in the UK, what's called box office here, of course. And you know it's going to do huge numbers.
Emma, are you motivated by winning another world title or is that a secondary consideration?
Yeah, under Joe Goosen, that's what we want. We want another world title fight. And looking at the rankings, there are some great champions in the 147 division. I've been there, I've been a world champion before, winning two world titles in the division, so I'm sure I can do it again. And but yeah, I'm only going to get better myself as well. You know, having 2 years at the ring for any fighter would be hard to get back into it. Now I want to get back in the flow again, I want to get back in the rhythm. And fighting for a world title, I bring a lot of money to the table when I fight, even in America. So if I fight a Garcia or a Porter or a Thurman or a Spence, I think that will bring big money to the table and those fights will take those fights.
Amir, you've also said that you're a businessman as well as a boxer. Are there any circumstances you'd consider of boxing at super welterweight?
No, I made that mistake before. Look, I made the one.
There's no big fights up there anyway.
No. I mean, the welterweight is the division. If you look at still in the world, the welterweight division is still the number one division out there. You've got all the biggest names. And, I don't want. I'll make 147 quite easy, even though I take my boxes off. I just think. Our skill, I think your skills are
right. Leave it. You used a set of bathroom scales. We had a calibrated set of scales. Who do you think was right or wrong?
Man, I'm calibrated. I swear, I'll put it 200.
By Joe.
I went to the mosque.
You shouldn't have
that. I was quite shocked when I saw her fight. Is Eddie catching me out here? Is he making me at 154 fight? He tried to push me up to 154.
Fight, Kelbrook. I want
to Eddie's I'm here, overweight now. You might as well be up to a division above. But look, we made it. Luckily, I had to take the boxes off and my socks off. And I was that confident that I left my socks on when I jumped on the scales. I thought I'll probably be bang on. But anyway, still made the weight, and it's probably been about over three years since I last made 147. That was against Algeria, so ages, you know. So it's good to be back in that mix again now. Go back in the rankings and see where they put me in.
So Eddie, on the basis of what Amir has just said there, what do you say to Cal Brook?
About what?
About the weight.
Amir's made it clear, and Kel's made it clear. 147 is where that fight would be if it was to take place.
Yeah. Hand on heart, though, Amir. You know, who are you going to choose in a couple of weeks' time? Manny Pacquiao or Cal Brook?
Don't get me wrong, I like the Manny Pacquiao fight, and I've said that he probably would be my first pick, depending where the fight's going to be, though. You know what I mean? But then, this is where we see the numbers and what makes more sense.
What means more to your legacy?
Man is a legend, look, man is a legend in the game. And to beat him, who's an 8-time world champion, we're massive.
So if you were to choose an order, it would be Pacquiao first and then Calvin?
Yeah, 100%.
I think there's a strong possibility we may work with Pacquiao anyway. So there is that triangle that might make sense, you know, where we could say to everybody, you know, this is the fight taking, the winner gets him, you know, and then everybody knows that if you win the fight, you have two super fights, and if you lose the first big super fight, you sail off into the sunset.
So you've got the trifecta going on, yeah?
The trifecta. All right, thanks everyone for coming. Thank you very much.